One of the things that has always fascinated me about my Apple Watch is this thing called heart rate variability. Apple tells you heart rate variability is a measure of the variation in time interval between two heartbeats, which is cool, but naturally I thought there must be so much more to it than just that. And so I did the research and was actually kind of surprised because, as it turns out, heart rate variability is actually kind of fascinating. Say you're lying in bed watching the latest and worst that Netflix has to offer. As usual, it's incredibly boring, and so, being bored, you have a resting heart rate of 60 beats per minute. You would expect your heart to beat precisely every single second within that 1 minute time frame, because I suppose we expect our hearts to function with almost mechanical precision.
But they don't.
Because biological systems aren't precise. Biological systems are often under the control of many different variables receiving hundreds of different inputs, both external and internal, and this is also true for your heart. In a healthy heart, you can expect to see some variation, with the interval between any two heartbeats never being quite the same. The time between two heartbeats could range from anything between 0.9 seconds to 1.15 seconds. That's completely normal and nothing to worry about. But more so than being completely normal or some weird biological anomaly, it appears that having a higher heart rate variability, or a heart that beats more erratically, may actually be a sign that you're in better health. It's well known, for example, that heart rate variability decreases dramatically with age, and it has been shown to be a prognostic indicator for survival following a cancer diagnosis. Perhaps more alarmingly, another study was able to illustrate that a lower heart rate variability was associated with a 40% increased likelihood of suffering a first cardiovascular event, a heart attack or a stroke. And it's not just your heart that's affected, because according to multiple studies, lower heart rate variability is associated with insulin resistance and diabetes. Low heart rate variability was even able to accurately predict the onset of major psychological illness, like major depression, 10 years before the onset of symptoms. Which kind of makes you think, why is it that low heart rate variability, or a more precise heart that beats exactly on the clock,
Why is that associated with ill health and disease?
Well, the answer is really simple. It's because your heart rate variability actually has very little to do with your heart. My name is Hesham, and I'm a University of Cambridge graduate and student doctor, and this is Doctor Tell Me Why, a medical YouTube channel where I get to read all about science and medicine and share the cool stuff that I learn with you guys. If you enjoyed this video, then that's amazing. You should totally subscribe and hit the bell icon to watch more videos just like this one. The topic for this video was chosen by you guys, so keep an eye out for any community polls and make sure you vote in them. I actually do listen and care about what you guys think. Now, back to where we left off. Well, the answer is really simple. It's because your heart rate variability actually has very little to do with your heart. This is because if your heart were left to its own devices, it will continue to beat, and beat it will at 100 beats per minute. This is due to a little patch of cells in your heart called a sinoatrial node, or cardiac pacemaker, that have their own internal rhythm and send off electrical signals to the rest of your heart, shouting at them to keep moving. Sorry, I mean beating. Obviously, your heart doesn't beat at 100 beats per minute, and that's because it receives input from your autonomic nervous system through its two main branches, the sympathetic and parasympathetic nervous systems. And so, if you're lying in bed and resting, your autonomic nervous system will send a message or an input to your heart through the vagus nerve telling it to and take things easy. If, however, you find yourself in a situation where you're scared, nervous, or even stressed out, your sympathetic nervous system will communicate to your heart and the rest of your body that it should be on high alert, ready to act at a moment's notice. And the balance between these two systems is what determines what your heart rate will be. And I know what you're probably thinking, that's heart rate, Hesham. What does all this have to do with heart rate variability? Well, a lot actually, because you can think of heart rate variability as being the love child, born out of the conflict between the two branches of the autonomic nervous system, parasympathetic and sympathetic. But in this case, conflict is good, as measured by heart rate variability, because conflict indicates that both branches of the autonomic nervous system are functioning properly. Pretty vital, as it's your autonomic nervous system that controls all the important things in your body that you don't even have to think about. Like using the toilet, for example. The unsung hero, if you like. In this line of thinking, heart rate variability is more of a proxy or a biomarker for autonomic function, reflecting a strong system that is more flexible and resilient and fully able to meet internal and external demands. One that can keep you healthy and free of disease. So much so that several scientists believe that a healthy long life depends on the preservation of autonomic function, more specifically the influence of the parasympathetic nervous system on heart rate variability. Guess it's important. Now let's talk about why someone might have a lower heart rate variability reading than expected. But before we do that, I think you should know that I've started a free newsletter on Substack. It's going to be bi-monthly and it's going to be a way for me to share all the cool medical and science stuff that I see on the internet every day and cannot possibly make videos about because everyone, including myself,
needs to sleep.
Sometimes. I'll send you links to articles along with summaries and key points like this article published in the New Yorker about why life expectancy in Costa Rica is significantly longer than it is in the United States, despite the obvious and large gap in GDP between the two countries. And if you want to learn more about heart rate variability, you'll find all the references I used in the making of this video over there too. It's free and you've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including my everlasting love. You'll find a link in the description below. So, heart rate variability. Heart rate variability appears to be extremely sensitive to even the slightest lifestyle changes, including poor sleep, psychological stress, and alcohol intake. In fact, one night of drinking was shown to reduce heart rate variability in a group of college athletes by up to 5 days. And one important study showed that those consuming a diet that was high in transsaturated fats showed consistently low heart rate variability readings compared to the control group.
5 years later.
Which naturally got me worried because despite being a relatively healthy 20-something year old who runs marathons and engages in strenuous physical exercise at the gym on an almost daily basis, according to my Apple Watch,
my heart rate variability is
it's regularly in the mid-40s and will occasionally even dip into the 30s, which is worryingly low for someone of my age. And I admit that like everyone, I get stressed out every now and then and am in the habit of eating more like a child than a grown adult man. But 22 milliseconds? But my heart rate variability readings aren't all that unusual. A lot of the very low readings tend to happen when I'm full on sprinting on the treadmill at the gym, or just after I've finished my workout. Acute decreases in heart rate variability have been reported among professional athletes following intense training. The effects were most pronounced in athletes taking part in endurance or resistance type exercise. The drop or dip in heart rate variability can actually be a good sign, a sign that you're doing something slightly more challenging and pushing your body outside of its comfort zone. Typically following an adequate rest or recovery period, heart rate variability will rebound and may even offshoot, showing significant improvement. So, in summary, strenuous physical exercise will result in a short-term drop in heart rate variability, but in the long term, with adequate rest and recovery, you should be fine if not better than fine. If you don't rest, however, or you don't wait for your heart rate variability to bounce back, you may be at risk of overtraining syndrome and fall into a slump of fatigue, reduced performance, and be more prone to ill health. Most scientists agree that the best time to measure heart rate variability is at night while you're fast asleep, to remove the effects any immediate external influences may have. Now, let's talk about the things that you can do to improve your heart rate variability, other than the obvious ones like exercising, sleeping well, and relaxing more. So while alcohol intake and smoking were shown to have a detrimental effect on heart rate variability, At least one study concludes that red wine consumption is associated with a higher heart rate variability. And pistachios are great too. Believe it or not, scientists did an experiment with pistachios and found a remarkable improvement in both heart rate variability and blood pressure. Changes in body weight appeared to have the biggest impact, however, with several studies demonstrating improved heart rate variability upon weight loss, with the degree of improvement correlating to the amount of weight lost. And other studies were able to demonstrate that weight gain resulted in reduced heart rate variability. And of course, there are some things that are just beyond your control, like your genes, for example. It's estimated that genetic factors account for around 30% of your heart rate variability. It appears that HRV is highly individualized and that some people just have lower heart rate variability readings than others. I guess what I'm trying to say is that instead of using your heart rate variability and comparing it to other people, you should use it for what it is, a powerful biomarker telling you exactly how your body is responding to all the various things that you keep throwing at it. Whether it be a new diet, stress at work, a few sleepless nights, or a night out with friends, falling variability is a sign that you should maybe take a step back before you break your body. I mean, just look at what happened to my heart rate variability after I got a good night's sleep after a week of
not sleeping very well.
157 milliseconds! There is hope for everyone, it seems. Even me. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more videos just like this. I haven't done any studies on this, but I'm fairly confident that my heart rate variability responds very positively to new subscribers. So subscribe. And don't forget to hit the bell icon so you get notified when I upload my video next week. See you all next week and try and stay safe until then.